Hello friends, welcome to our channel Learn and Have Fun. In this video, we will learn about refraction of light through a glass slab. For this activity, we will take a black paper as a background for laser beam. We have placed four tablets on the black paper, which serve as a platform for the glass slab. Friends, these are simple paracetamol tablets used to raise the glass slab slightly above the surface for better clarity of the laser beam. For the activity, we are taking a powerful green laser torch. Now switch it on. We can observe the laser beam travel in a straight line in air medium, but when it is passing through the glass slab, it bends. This bending of laser beam or visible light when it travels from one transparent medium to the other is known as refraction of light. Let's first discuss refraction with normal incidence of laser beam. Here, the laser beam is falling normally on the glass slab, that means angle of incidence is 0 degree. So here, light travel straight in glass slab without any bending or refraction. Now change the direction of laser beam and increase the angle of incidence. You will observe a slight bending of laser beam towards the normal in the glass slab. Increase the angle of incidence further and you can see the amount of bending of laser beam also increases. Observe the refraction of laser beam through a different angle for better clarity. Here you can see in air medium the laser goes straight, but when it enters the glass medium, bending takes place. Let's now understand the phenomenon of refraction deeply. Here we have two different medium in which light is traveling. Air and glass. In air, the speed of light is high, very close to its maximum speed in vacuum, which is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And in glass, light travels slower, approximately 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. We call air as rarer medium since light travels faster in it, and glass as denser medium as light travels slower in it. The ray which is falling on the glass slab is known as incident ray. The incident ray on entering the glass slab bends and then it is known as refracted ray. The ray that comes out of the glass slab is known as emergent ray. A line perpendicular to the glass slab at the point of incidence is called the normal. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of incidence. Similarly, the angle between refracted ray and normal is known as angle of refraction. And angle between emergent ray and normal is known as angle of emergence. If light is incident normally on the glass slab, then angle of incidence is 0 degree. In such a case, the ray will go straight even though there is a change in speed of light, as it is the shortest path through which light can travel in the glass medium. There is no bending occur in this case. As we increase the angle of incidence of laser beam, that is any value other than 0, it bends. Here in this case, it bends towards the normal as it travels from a rarer medium air to denser medium glass. When light comes out of the glass slab, opposite happens. Light bends away from the normal. This happens because light is traveling from a denser medium glass to a rarer medium air. Watch once again the laser show as we change the angle of incidence from 0 degree to 90 degree on both sides of the normal. Now we are using two laser torches which are joined using glue. We change the orientation of the laser beam such that both the laser beams appear to coincide when viewed from the top. That means from the camera angle, we will see only one laser beam instead of two. We now pass the lower laser beam through the glass slab and the upper laser beam continues to move in the air. You can see the emergent beam which come out of the glass slab is parallel to the incident beam. When observed from a different angle, you can see two laser beams. One is passing through air and the other through glass slab. As the opposite side of the glass slabs are parallel, you can easily prove through your knowledge of geometry that emergent beam should be parallel to the incident beam. Watch it again. Now we will pass both the laser beam through the glass slab. Observe that the same amount of bending is taking place for both the laser beam as the angle of incidence is same for both. Now we will use two glass slabs to show how ray of light goes from air to glass slab 1 and then air and again to glass slab 2. Now let's observe how bending of light takes place if we replace the glass slab with a plastic box containing water. We will observe laser beam is not clearly visible in the water. Now I am going to add few drops of Dettol in water to increase the scattering effect. It will make the laser beam slightly visible in the water. Now pass the laser beam through this water. You will observe bending of light in water is less as compared to bending of light in glass. This shows water is rarer than glass. Repeating the activity again with laser going from glass to water. This is our attempt to explain the phenomenon of refraction using laser beam. Hope you like it. Please like, share, comment and subscribe our channel. Learn and have fun. Thank you.